morning to all. Welcome back to Max Online Classes. Actually, we are dealing with the chapter 5, quadrilateral geometry, and we have done some problems in exercise number 5.2. Now we are going to continue question number 9 in exercise number 5.2. Okay. The question is: show that the given points form a right-angled triangle, and check whether they satisfy Pythagoras' theorem. Okay. So show that the given points form a right angle triangle. What it means? Three points are given. If it forms a right angle triangle, means one of the angle must be 90 degree. One of the angle must be 90 degree. For example, if you join these three points, you will get the triangle. Okay? Like this. Okay? So this straight line, this line segment is perpendicular to this line segment. How do we show that? So, the slope of this line and slope of this straight line, product of these two is equal to minus 1. Okay? Not necessary to these two straight line. It may also. Okay? So, first we show that their slopes, product of their slopes is equal to minus 1. Okay. So, if the product of the slope equal to minus 1 means, we can say that one of the angle is equal to 90 degree. So, in a triangle, any one of the angle is equal to 90 degree means, it is a right triangle. Okay. The second concept, they satisfy Pythagoras' theorem or not. Here, we apply a distance between two points formula. So, find the distance of this one and this one and this one. So, sum of these two is equal to this one. Sum of it means in the right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse, it is the hypotenuse. The square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Okay, so we start first one. Condition. So first I am going to show m1 into m2 equal to minus 1. Slope of AB. First I take A and B. So, slope of AB formula y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. M is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. You know that this is x1, y1, x2, y2. So, y2 minus y1 means minus 3, minus 2 minus plus, plus 4 divided by y2, 2 minus 1. So, minus 3 plus 4 gives plus 1. And 2 minus 1 gives 1. So 1 by 1 is equal to 1. So first I find the slope of AB. After that, slope of BC. Now this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2. So y2 minus y1, minus 7, minus 2, this minus becomes plus 7. And x2 minus x1, 4 minus 2. Minus 7 plus 3 gives minus 4. Divided by 4 minus 2 gives 2. So we will get minus 2. Slope of BC equal to minus 2. The third is slope of AC. Slope of AC. So A 1 comma minus 1. X1 y1. This is x2 y2. So y2 minus y1. Minus 7 and y1 value is minus 4, minus into minus plus divided by and x2 4 minus 1 minus 7 into sorry minus 7 plus 4 gives minus 3 divided by 4 minus 1 gives 3. We get minus 1. Look at this, slope of AB is 1 and the slope of AC is minus 1. If you multiply them, if you multiply them, you can get minus 1. Here, slope of AB into slope of AC is equal to 1 into minus 1 gives minus 1. So, product of the slopes is equal to minus 1 means they are perpendicular. They are perpendicular. Therefore, the given points will form a right triangle. Will form a right triangle. The next term, whether they satisfy Pythagoras theorem or not. I hope you all understood the first concept. First, we showed the given points will form a right angle triangle by using the concept of slope. Actually, here three slopes we found: slope of AB, slope of BC, and the slope of AC. If the product of any two slopes, whatever it is, any two slopes product is equal to minus 1, means any two side lengths is perpendicular. Okay, any two side lengths are perpendicular to each other. That's why we can say the given points will form a right triangle. Okay. Now move to the second one. Satisfies Pythagoras theorem. So here distance between two points formula. Distance between two points D is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. This is the formula for finding distance between two points. First, I am going to find the distance between AB, because it is a right triangle. If you take this as A, this is B, this is C. The square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. We do not know about the AC, AB and the BC. We just find the AB, BC and the AC distance. After finding that, the greatest value is equal to sum of other two values or not. We just verify it, okay? So first AB, I am going to find AB distance. So A is equal to 1 comma minus 4, B is equal to 2 comma minus 3. So x2 minus x1 the whole square. So 2 minus 1 the whole square plus y2 is minus 3 and y1 is minus 4. Minus into minus plus 4 the whole square. 2 minus 1, 1, 1 square value 1 plus minus 3 plus 4 value plus 1, 1 square value 1. So square root of 2. This is AB. Okay, so what is AB square? AB square is equal to 2. AB is equal to 2 means AB square is equal to 2. Okay, like BC. X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square. Better we write B and C points. B 2 comma minus 3 and C is 4 comma minus 7. This is x1, this is y1, x2, y2. So x2 minus x1, 4 minus 2 the whole square plus minus 7 y2 minus 2 minus plus 3 the whole square. So 4 minus 2 gives 2, 2 square value 4 plus minus 7 plus 3 gives 4, 4 square value 16. So square root of 4 plus 16 gives 20, root 20. This is BC. So what about BC square is equal to 20. When you take square on both sides, the square root will be cancelled. So BC square equal to 20. Like AC. What is A? A is equal to 1 comma minus 4. First I write A 1 comma minus 4. And C is 4 comma minus 7, x1, y1, x2, y2. So AC is equal to square root of x2 minus x1. So 4 minus 1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1. So minus 7 is minus into minus plus 4 the whole square. Listen, 4 minus 1 is 3, 3 square value 9. Plus minus 7, minus 7 plus 4 gives minus 3. Minus 3 square value is plus 9. So we get 18, square root of 18. This is AC. So what about AC square? AC square is equal to plus 18. Look at this. AB square equal to 2 and BC square equal to 20 and AC square equal to 18. So from these three you can get an idea. So this BC side is the longest side. The longest side value which is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. So we can write it as BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square. Yes, BC square value is 20. This 20 is equal to AB square value 2 plus AC square value 18. So 20 is equal to 20. Hence, it satisfies Pythagoras theorem. Actually, this is first subdivision in question number 9. So, I will give you as a homework. The second subdivision is your homework. Try to do like this. Okay. First, show that the given points will form a right triangle by using the concept of slope. After that, verifying by using distance between two points formula. If any one of the side length is equal to greater, so the other two sum which is satisfies that one means. We can say it satisfies Pythagoras theorem like that. BC square equal to AB square plus AC square in this case. Sometimes AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. It may change according to the given problem. I hope you understand. This is important 5 mark question. Learn properly. Question number 10. Exercise number 5.2. Show that the given points form a parallelogram. This is the question. If you join the four points, you can get a mathematical shape that is a parallelogram. This is it. Okay. So show that the given points form a parallelogram means if you join them, you can get a parallelogram like this. You must know the properties of parallelogram. It is a four-sided closed mathematical shape. Four-sided closed mathematical shape. Here, pair of opposite sides are parallel and equal. A, B, C, D. This AB is parallel to CD. And this BC is parallel to AD. Okay? And you know that sum of the interior angles of the parallelogram is equal to 360 degree. You know this concept. So here the concept of slope we are going to apply. AB is parallel to CD. How to show that? AB is parallel to CD. It means slope of AB equal to slope of CD. If you say slope of AB equal to slope of CD means you can write like this. AB is parallel to CD. Similarly, slope of BC is equal to slope of AD means we can say BC is parallel to AD. Okay. So slope formula M is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So we find one by one. First AD followed by CD, next BC, next AD. Okay. So first slope of AD. Slope of CD. So A, the point A is equal to 2.5 and B is 10 comma minus 4. You can take this as M1. M1. You know that y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this is x1, this is y1, x2, y2, y2 minus y1, minus 4, minus 3.5, divided by x2, 10 minus 2.5, minus 4, minus 3.5 gives minus 7.5, divided by 10 minus 2.5 gives 7.5. If you cancel, you can get minus 1. So M1 is equal to minus 1. Similarly, slope of CD. What is C? 2.5 comma minus 2.5, and D is minus 5 comma plus 5. You know that x1, y1, x2, y2. You can take this as M. So y2 minus y1, 5 minus into minus plus. So 5 plus 2.5 divided by minus 5. In form of minus is A. So minus 2.5. 5 plus 2.5 gives 7.5. And minus 5 minus 2.5 gives minus 7.5. If you cancel this, you can get minus 1. This is M2. Okay. So from 1 and 2, we get the slope of AB equal to slope of CD. You must find this slope of AB equal to slope of CD. Therefore, AB is parallel to CD. AB is parallel to CD. Like we are going to find the slope of BC and the slope of AD. So next I am going to show slope of BC equal to slope of AD. If slope of BC equal to slope of AD means I can say BC is parallel to AD. So I took B value and the C value here. So here M1. Slope of BC be M1. So y2 minus y1. Minus 2.5. This one minus into minus plus 2. Divided by 2.5. x2 minus x1, so 2.5 minus 10. So minus 2.5 plus 4 gives plus 1.5 divided by 2.5 minus 10 gives minus 7.5. If you simplify it, 1 times here, 5 times. So minus 1 by 5. So m1 is equal to minus 1 by 5. Like the slope of AD be M2, y2 minus y1, 5 minus 3.5 divided by minus 5 minus 2.5. So 5 minus 3.5 gives 1.5 divided by minus 7.5. 1 times 5 times minus 1 by 5. This is M2. So M1 is equal to M2. So we can write it as slope of BC is equal to slope of AD. Hence, BC is parallel to AD. Okay. So come to the conclusion. Here we got pair of opposite sides. Pair of opposite sides are parallel. How? This BC is parallel to AD and AD is parallel to CD. Therefore, pair of opposite sides are parallel. So, the given points will form a parallelogram. I hope you all understand the concept. So we will see the next problem in next class. Thank you.